we've revealed the archaeology of an average middling Roman town, and this prompts us to reconsider important aspects of life in the Roman world. The site is located basically in between Rome and Naples in central Italy, in plain sight of the famous Abbey of Monte Cassino. What draws us there is precisely this, the fact that it looked so underwhelming as to make it interesting. It is traditionally understood that Roman Italy experienced an early decline, even compared to the rest of the empire, starting at the end of the 1st century AD. Demographic, economic, and definitely political, lost its preeminence within the broader Roman world and its empire. What our research made it possible to see instead is this average middling community that by all accounts should have only declined, in fact continuing and thriving well into the 3rd century AD. Our study of Interamna Lirenas has given us a very detailed and complete plan of an average Roman town throughout all its history, a town made up of three baths, an intramural sanctuary, a roof theater, several public buildings and houses of any kind, from apartment blocks to, you know, the kind of large house that you would see in Pompeii, for example. And it has allowed us basically to zoom in to details of their life. The recovery of the inscribed sundial telling us of the success of a member of this community in Rome, and he decided to celebrate it back in his hometown. At the same time, you know, the tiny details relating to the decoration of the theater, the marbles, the colored marbles that were brought from all over the Mediterranean to decorate possibly part of the Scaena, the background of the theater, and all the tiny architectural terracottas that decorated its majestic roof. None of the methodologies that we used were new when we started. We knew there was a theater because we carried out a geophysical survey, an archaeological prospection without digging. The moment we dug, we discovered it wasn't just a theater, but a roof theater. There were clear signs that the region had a roof, and that is quite a rare, not unique, but definitely rare occurrence in Italy at the time. It suggested that this community had taste or wanted something that was quite unique and peculiar. The study of the local regional pottery was extremely interesting because when studying Roman Italy in the imperial period, we traditionally relied on the presence of pottery imported from the provinces. Now, this would have made it difficult for us to see people and to see periods that in fact commonware pottery, which was locally produced, regionally available, and therefore more accessible, made it possible for us to see. Had we relied exclusively on this kind of imported material culture, we would have seen a decline at Interamna Lirenas already in the 1st century AD. But in fact, by looking at commonware pottery, we were able to map not just its continuity, but its success throughout the 2nd and even the earlier part of the 3rd century AD. Archaeology is the kind of endeavor that is really out there in the world, at the boundary between a remote past and a very much alive present. To understand why the Roman world came to an end requires us to understand what makes it stand up for so long. And I think to look at the structure, the functioning structure of communities in the Roman world at this level of detail, which is made possible by reconstructing the plan of an average Roman town, by seeing how accessible material culture made it possible for people to thrive, even at a time when they were not being the center of the world anymore, is very important and may pave the way for a better understanding of how the Roman world really worked.